Hello, my wonderful pupils. Hope you are doing good. Today's topic is informal letter. Informal letter. Informal letter. Last time on letter writing, we discussed the types of letters and we discussed informal letters and formal letters. So today, we'll be writing an informal letter. I'll state the formats for writing an informal letter. Remember, informal letter is a friendly letter. You write to your sisters, your brothers, your friends, your father or your mother. It is a friendly letter. So today, we'll be writing a letter to your father, inviting him to your school's PTA. That is Parents Teachers Association. You'll be writing an informal letter to your father, inviting him to your school's PTA. Remember, informal letter has one address. Informal letter has one address, which is the writer's address. Who is the writer? The writer is the person writing the letter. The writer is the person writing the letter. So let's begin. For this purpose, we'll be using the school's address. 1 Grace Court Drive, Doka Housing Estate, Oka, Fuso, 8 June 2020. By looking at my address, you can see that every letter, or rather every word, begins with capital G. The first letter of every word begins with capital letter. Capital D for drive, capital G for grace, capital C for courts, Udoka, capital U, capital H, capital S. And there's another thing you can notice, it is well punctuated. You can see my comma and my full stop. The full stop means that that is the end of my address. You can see comma, comma, and the full stop. And my date after the month, there's a comma after the month. So this is the writer's address. You are the writer. If you're asked to write a letter to your father or your mother, you are the writer. So this is your address. The next thing is salutation. The next thing is salutation. You use dear dad or dear daddy. Dear daddy. After that, you add your comma. You add your comma. After the salutation, the next thing is content of the letter. It could be referred to as body of the letter or content of the letter. Here, you write everything you want your father to do. Here, you state your purpose for writing to your father. I've always told my students to divide the content into three paragraphs. Divide the content into three paragraphs. The first one, you greet your father, you exchange pleasantries, you ask him how he's doing his business. And the second paragraph, you state your purpose of writing the letter. You invite him to your school's PTA. After that, you tell him the time, the date, and the venue. Then the third paragraph, you just write anything. It's just a concluding paragraph. You can tell your daddy to take care of himself, that you're missing him. That's if he's not with you at the moment. So remember, I'm showing you the format for writing an informal letter. This is a paragraph. The small space here signifies paragraph. So your first paragraph is exchange of pleasantries. Then the second paragraph, you tell your dad the purpose of writing to him. Then the final paragraph, you conclude. than tell your daddy to buy something for you when he's coming back, or that you miss him, and so on. After that, we have complimentary clothes. Complimentary clothes. If you write it to your father, you can say, "Yours sincerely." It's accepted in an informal letter. "Yours sincerely." You can say, "Your loving son," or "Your loving daughter." You can also write, "Yours truly." But for today, we'll be using "Yours sincerely." "Yours sincerely." You can see it ends with a comma. Then you add your first name. You add your first name because it's an informal letter. You do not add your surname. If your name is Okafor Michael, you don't need to write Michael because Michael is, you don't need to write Okafor rather because Okafor is your surname. You just write Michael. You can see, "Yours sincerely, Michael." "Yours sincerely, Michael." Hope you learned something. If you've learned something, practice how to write an informal letter. Make sure you go to your class studio for your assignment. See you next time. Bye.